Welcome to Suncoast View. I'm Stephanie Roberts. We are celebrating Linda today as she turns 78 years young.
I'm Kathy Carson, Linda's daughter, and I'm here to try and embarrass her with stories for a change.
I'm Bo Beth. We have Linda's favorite store, her favorite performer, and many more surprises for her big day.
And I'm the birthday girl, Linda Carson, and I am ready to show these girls what 78 is all about. All that and more right now on Suncoast View. Getting old. You worried about being 35. 78 is so great. You can get away with anything at my age and you don't get pregnant.
That's the best welcome I could provide. Welcome to the show. We are celebrating Linda and her upcoming 78th birthday today. We welcome her daughter, Kathy Carson, who is already turning three shades of red after 5 seconds.
I can't handle it.
She's like, this is a bad idea. We invited Kathy just so she could blush and ask her mother my favorite line ever, who says things like that?
She does. She says things like that all the time. She's not just here, all the time.
She's a dignified attorney, so I am embarrassing her all the time.
I thought you were going to embarrass her.
I think that would be impossible. Probably.
We're going to try, though. We're going to try. Well, I want to start by lifting a glass and saying cheers for Linda. Now, Linda is not much of a drinker, but she will admit to absolutely loving margaritas.
I do.
So a big thanks to our friends at Table Creekside for making us special margaritas. Ooh. The pink drinks are their Summer Ritas, and they're a strawberry jalapeno margarita.
Yeah.
We know you like your life a little spicy.
The mixologist told me I might not be able to handle this.
Oh, all right. It is almost happy hour.
And then the challenge.
Girls, you are drinking honeydew vodka mojitos, and these are some of the summer specials on hand at Table Creekside. So enjoy, enjoy.
Nice.
Big thanks to them, and cheers to Linda.
Oh, it tastes so good.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
We like the birthday. You've got confetti stuck on yours. We want to see who's in the kitchen today. We also welcome John Parr from Yoder's. What are we making today?
Today we're making red beans and rice.
Red beans and rice. Okay, now you mentioned, Linda's not much of a cook. We have to keep mentioning these things here, that she could provide great meals simply by stopping by your store. Tell us about sides like red beans and rice and what you offer at the store.
Sure. Down at the deli, we have a lot of our traditional meals, like the meatloaf and some of our scalloped potatoes, all that kind of stuff that we stock on a regular basis. And this is one of the side dishes that we offer.
And, of course, there's pies involved. I'm assuming we can grab those there as well.
Small ones.
Every holiday we've had since we moved to Sarasota, we've had yogurt pies.
Yoder's pies
are just awesome. My son has flown to Atlanta holding a pecan pie from Yoder's because there's just nothing like their pies.
Well, perfect to have them here for the celebration then. And we did think that you probably have spent at least a couple years of your 78 years sitting
eating.
There. Eating? No, eating, but also
sure
sitting there.
Ordered sides from them.
I think so. Yes. Oh, Linda, I'm sure this is for you. You want to invite someone in?
Come in. I'm afraid to ask. Come in. Oh, my goodness. It's my birthday present from last year. Where have you been, you guys?
All right.
I got these guys for my birthday last year, and they wouldn't let me take them home.
I was going to say, I haven't seen them.
Wow.
You will get to celebrate.
Somebody
as well.
Take a picture so everybody knows this happened.
Yes, Linda likes to post this on Facebook to make her other 78-year-old girlfriends jealous.
All my girlfriends will go wild within me.
So, Linda, let us explain and, of course, introduce
No
Kathy,
explanation needed.
Probably not. To Chase and Ryan from Scorch Fitness. They have visited us before, and Linda is a very big fan. So
yes.
We appreciate you coming in, looking so fit. And
look at Linda's smile.
And I'm so young already.
Now, the cake definitely needs a fun story.
Oh, look at that.
So our senior producer, Joey, asked Kathy, what is Linda like? Like, what's some of her favorite themes? Kathy, what did you reply?
Murder. She likes murder.
I like murder.
She likes murder.
I do like murder.
So we called Sift Bakehouse, our friend Christine, and she said, we can do murder. Sift Bakehouse can do a themed cake of any variety.
Oh.
Now, who asks for a murder-themed cake? Yeah. I can only imagine. But we decided that you do like murder.
I
Kathy
do.
Said
I watch ID Discovery all night long because it's so awesome. One murder after another.
So
it's
we have
beautiful.
A red velvet cake with plenty of dripping red
blood.
On it and the red roses with
I'm
kind
gonna,
of a sexy
turn
touch.
It around. You can see the shards of what looks of to be like a glass
of
or
glass.
Knife that's
oh,
going to... You
yes.
see it?
Yes, with the chocolate.
Yes.
Oh, that's wonderful.
That's beautiful. Yes.
And in the stories, these would be the guys who are the killers.
Oh, yes.
This is why we wouldn't let her take us home.
That is a very
smart
thing.
You don't want to rethink this, I guess.
I bet the birthday girl would like a kiss. So
wow. It's been a long time.
And continue our celebration. We have many more guests that want to say hello to you. Thank you, Chase. Thank you, Ryan.
Thank you, guys.
Always great to
Linda. See you next year.
But, Linda, the greetings continue not with just our friends that are here today, but many other familiar faces. Let's take a look.
Hey, Linda Boo. Happy birthday, beautiful sister. I love you, Linda. Happy birthday. Many, many more. I can't wait to see you guys next week.
Hi, Linda. It's not a goat. It's a gator.
Happy birthday from the Players Center for Performing Arts.
Thank you for all you do for us.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Linda.
Hi, Linda. Everybody just wanted to say
happy birthday.
This is your birthday song. It isn't very long.
Happy birthday, Linda.
Buon compleanno.
Happy birthday, Linda.
From the cast of Light in the Piazza at Freefall Theater.
Hi, happy birthday to you, Linda Carson. From me, Linda Larson.
Happy birthday, Linda. I hope it is fantastic. You really do prove that age is just a number.
Have a great birthday and have a drink on me.
Happy birthday, Linda Carson, from all of us at Manatee Performing Arts Center.
Happy birthday to you.
Wow.
Oh, so many friends and family
oh,
wanting
so
to greet
wonderful.
You.
It brings tears to my eyes.
Good. Aww. And while we were looking at our greetings, we did cut the cake. I want you to notice the red interior
oh,
of our red velvet
everywhere. Blood everywhere.
And I'm
yes.
making a mess, but that is okay.
This well, sounds like a good movie.
You need to write a book, Linda.
Yes,
Kathy,
you
do. We've been telling her that for years. If she ever sits down
yeah,
long
you'll
enough.
Be in trouble.
No, thanks.
Well, Linda, tell. Linda has had a thing for birthday boys in the past. We always talk about last year's birthday celebration because not only did she have a birthday boy deliver her cake, but we ended up using him as the birthday card and actually signing him. I feel bad for that poor guy. He was the nicest and most patient person ever. So this year we had to beat it and have two birthday boys.
Aww.
But the other fun thing you may remember, Linda, we did special L for your cake because Linda's
special
favorite
K.
thing in life is special K. But because Kathy's here, we didn't bring any special K this year because I hear Kathy doesn't like your special K habit.
I
Kathy?
Am addicted to special K cereal, I admit it.
I just am not an enabler, okay? When people hide things, it means they shouldn't have
she
them.
Hides cereal?
She hides
she throws
cereal.
It out.
I do.
Okay.
It's weird to hide cereal. It is.
Or at least she's not hiding
just put
bottles.
It under the bed because it's more convenient
oh,
that way.
Please.
Or maybe behind the commode. You know?
Oh my gosh,
you're hiding
cereal
in your
bathroom
behind your commode?
See, we should never
this
think
is why,
to look there.
This is why I throw this stuff out. This is
the
problem.
You. Yes, that's bizarre. Well, no special cake
why
this year.
Why not the cabinet?
Right?
She put there first.
No, I wouldn't even notice it. It's cereal in a cabinet.
Nothing beats mother-daughter interaction. I absolutely
love it.
Love it. We love it. All right, it is time for our first hot topic. And Linda, take note, This is what could happen if you party too much for your birthday. A Tampa Bay Bucks player wakes up early Sunday morning trapped in a museum. Wide receiver Lewis Murphy was at the wedding of a fellow NFL player at the Flag Museum in Palm Beach. Murphy says, all right, he had a fair amount to drink. He fell asleep on the stairs in the museum's courtyard. When he woke up, everyone was gone and he was locked in. He reportedly had to break some glass to even get to a phone and call a friend. Police say he will not be charged. Linda, you have a story for everything. You ever been locked in anywhere?
His friends don't like him.
My husband and I were looking at houses when we moved here. The realtor was showing us new houses, and I thought, well, they'll never notice. I'm going to sneak in this bathroom. So I sneaked in the bathroom, shut the door. They went out the back door, and I was locked in. Nobody could hear me. No cell phone at that point.
No cell
phones back then. So I wonder I'm not still in this house. Of course, Kathy gets locked in more exciting places.
I got locked in the Cavs bathroom at the old stadium. I was camping out. I was in high school camping out for Grateful Dead tickets. And they let us into the arena, but whoever let us sneak in there didn't realize we needed to get back out. So we were locked in their locker room all night long.
Uh-huh. What did you do?
Eventually, it became light out, and a security guard came in and let us out.
Okay. I was hoping there were no guys involved. You don't remember this story?
Huh? You don't remember that story?
She thought I was sleeping over at someone's house.
Oh, my goodness.
She was at Susie's house.
I'm sure there was some cover going on there. All right, well, here's the gift to give someone that has tried almost everything. You can now pay to join the Mile High Club with no risk of public embarrassment. Cincinnati's Flamingo Air is for flyers to fulfill their dream of having sex in the sky. For $495, you get a private hour-long flight of fancy, they call it. The owners say that thousands of very straight-laced couples have enjoyed this service in the unique atmosphere, including a couple celebrating their 60th anniversary and a couple with 8 kids just looking for time to themselves. All right, Kathy, I hate to bring up your mom's sex life.
And we're sorry.
Why? We apologize right now. But Linda, I guess we don't need to get you this. You're already in the Mile High Club.
Oh, it was my husband. It was a flight from L.A. to Atlanta. And it was in the back seat. Come on.
Okay, Why is this happening to me?
Are you a member?
No.
Good. Don't go there.
And if you do, $495, it'll be private.
It'll be nice.
It'll be private. It will be okay.
All right,
I'm going to spare Kathy any more of this story. So the Mega Millions jackpot continues to grow. I know Bo Beth is watching.
No, you're okay.
You have until tonight. Now, it's at $540 million for our Friday night drawing. But if you play, don't forget to check your ticket. A New Jersey woman was cleaning her house. She ended up with the surprise of her life. Yocasta Boyer found an old lottery ticket while searching through some papers. She asked her brother just kind of randomly, I'll go check the number on it. Worth $472,000. It was only days away from expiring.
Oh.
She cashed the ticket in and has a nice chunk of change.
That's
amazing.
That would
be a good way to celebrate the big birthday.
Let's look through the cushions when we get home.
You may find cereal, you may find a lottery
more
ticket.
More cereal's more likely.
And of course, that big drawing Friday night. Let's do another cheers to Linda and Kathy for being such a good sport.
More to Kathy because she's so embarrassed.
I need a drink.
The stories never stop with Linda. We absolutely love it. We're going to take a look at our happy hour forecast. And when we come back, Kathy, one of Linda's favorite stores is here.
More bears.
You may be surprised what it is. Stay with us.
It's not Macy.
Slightly more active than it was 24 hours ago. Temperatures a little bit warmer as well, helping to trigger off showers and thunderstorms. A kind of light wind flow, and some of the storms are interacting with other storms and creating kind of a mishmash of shower activity and thunderstorm activity inland. By far, though, the biggest storms are located over or have been located over Lakewood Ranch area, where they've seen perhaps even some pea-sized hail out there, as well as some heavy downpours of rain. If you take a look at a slice of this particular storm and therefore look at the storm heights with time over the last 45 minutes or so, you'll notice that the height of the storm has substantially shrunk, as well as the number of lightning strikes. So an indication that the storm is in the process of dissipation. We also have a pretty big storm located over the Northport area. This will be the case through the afternoon hours and into the early evening. Storms and thunderstorms popping up here and there, mostly east of the interstate.
One of my favorite moments with Linda is when we were planning Stephanie's bachelorette party. Linda volunteered to go to Giggles and get party favors. Yes, she did. Then she proceeded to get pretty much everything in the entire store. Little did we know, Linda is a frequent customer at Giggles in Sarasota. So in her honor today, Kathy Clampett is here with adult novelties to help us celebrate Linda.
Yay!
And whenever I come to your store, I bring my daughter, Kathy.
That sounds really weird.
You can find great gifts there.
And you can.
When you give these gifts, it makes everybody smile. So we've done a lot of bridal showers, a lot of birthday parties. It's just straight fun.
Did you hire her?
She's good. She's hired. She's on the payroll.
All right, so you already have some of the gifts that you can get there. I see a crown, the boa. What's going on?
This is all you're supposed to wear, actually, the crown, the boa, and the princess button.
Oh, let me see.
But at 78, you have to add a few.
Oh, hold your boa so we can see the princess button.
Princess,
what does it say?
Actually, it should say queen.
Birthday princess.
Yes.
That is perfect.
Kathy and I were there buying a few items for a bachelor party, and she said, Mom, I hope nobody sees us in here. And suddenly a man comes over and says, oh, hi, Linda, can I have your autograph?
That's not Kathy, how it went. How it went is we were in there and everybody was like, that's Linda Carson. There's Linda Carson. Look, Linda Carson's in here and she's, what is she looking at? And I was like, everybody notices you. And then that guy was like, hey, can I get your autograph? But he was there too, so what was he going to tell me?
All right, it's so funny.
Well, right in front of Linda, there's also a glass. I like this. What is that?
That is her birthday girl glass.
Oh.
Because any birthday grand dame must have a special glass.
Oh, absolutely.
To carry your margarita in.
And it matches your boa.
It does. Very elegant.
All right, so now we're going to start at other things you can actually get at the store. Let's go to the mask. Now, Linda, if you had this while you were there, they would not have recognized
you. Kathy, next time I've got to wear a mask when we go there.
That would be perfect.
That would be.
We put it a little bit like that.
Nobody would know.
No one would know. No one would know.
I'd say, who's that crazy woman?
You want to go out tonight?
I think you would still get lots of attention.
That's the point. It's her eyes wide shut look.
I didn't know she had one.
You will be a hit no matter what.
Oh, thank you. Well, now that'll make anybody a hit.
We'll get there.
Yeah, but before that, is that a masquerade mask or is it for...
I don't know what the right word is. You know, you could be very imaginative and very creative. It could be a masquerade mask. Be Halloween.
But Kathy, you do have a lot of adult costumes for any type of holiday.
It could be a play date.
Sexy.
And that would be pretty with, Linda.
Let's not move it so we can get the shots.
I don't think I'm going to look real good in that one.
That one?
That's more of Bobeth.
We can talk about that. Bobeth, hold that up a second here. Hold it up where? Hold it up where it's designed to be held. So, a bustier of types?
That's you, Bobeth.
Is it? Now I'm going to be blushing.
It's your new look.
It's all good.
And what would I wear this with? It would be hot at the beach.
You could probably wear it with a long flowing skirt when you wanted to be particularly enchanted.
Yeah, you probably shouldn't take it in the water, though.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
I don't think it's beach wear. Just to walk on the beach. But, Kathy, you do sell swimwear at Giggles, correct?
Yes.
I think that's just great.
We sell lots of swimwear.
So many different things. I like the gems on the bottom.
I told you you'd like it.
A whole lot of things
would be dazzled. I just have to find somewhere to wear it to. We can work on that. Well, I know one of Linda's favorite colors, as you've noticed, is blue. So, Kathy, show us about the
Joey told me that Linda is very fond of massage, and who isn't?
Oh, my goodness.
And this would be very nice to just tickle and massage.
Ooh, now I may blush.
It's fun and it's erotic.
And to go along, that does feel very nice.
And it matches your gown.
Oh, it does.
Yes.
It looks like you should be holding that.
It's not my birthday, everyone, but you match.
And also, since Linda's so fond of massage, we brought along some warming massage oil because we all like to have that warm, wonderful sensation on our skin. And this one is also flavored.
Flavored massage oil.
The dogs would love that.
Yes.
She's got two little dogs named Meatball and Filet Mignon. That's so wild.
Great names.
So you massage and then tickle.
Yes.
And then a way to lighten the mood a little bit, maybe, and give some ideas.
Yes. This is a fun, it's a fun little game. It's called Love to Party. It, when we were children, we all played like with the Magic Eight Ball.
Okay.
And only this is a little more, it's a little more suggestive.
Uh-oh. Like, a little.
Especially if you go out with a party of young women and or all age women, there are different things come up.
All right,
like,
so do a dare just came up.
Oh, do a dare.
Do
so
a dare.
You walk up to the bar and hand this to a strange
no,
guy?
No, we're going to tell you to do
tell
a dare.
You
yeah, we're
going
to tell
do.
You to do a dare.
Oh, to do a dare.
Right. I dare you to wear that the rest of the day.
I am going for a massage.
And she's taking her feathers with her.
Yes. And her warm oil.
Oil.
All right, well, thank you so much, Kathy. Now, you, of course, you can always get all of these things at Giggles in Sarasota. And you can go to their website, which is right on their screen because I can't see that. And next, Linda's favorite entertainer sings to us. We'll be right back.
Hurricane season is here, and Suncoast weather can go from this to this in seconds. So when severe weather threatens, count on the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7.
We're armed with the most advanced weather technology so that we can bring you storm warnings faster and with more detail than ever before.
Plus, we focus on the Suncoast and track storms right down to your neighborhood.
On air, online, and on your mobile device, turn to the official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
Mom needed more care than we could provide, so we called Granny Nannies. She now has around-the-clock caregivers, and we have peace of mind. Thanks to them, she's where she belongs, at home.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Monday at 5 on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast.
Hello, I'm Rebecca Vargas.
And I'm Don Brennan. The temperature is only going up here in Florida, and so is the risk for heat-related illnesses.
Monday on Good Morning Suncoast, we'll show you the symptoms to be on the lookout for heat stroke and how to prevent it. Wendy?
And there's the possibility we'll start to see some rain coming back in our forecast, and we sure could use it.
Monday at 5 on ABC 7's Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you. On the next Black Almanac.
Greatness Beyond Measure celebrates this ninth year with a weekend of activities for youth from 12 to 19 that are powerful beyond measure. The entertainers, speakers, and workshops are audacious and will create a potent mix of learning. For youth will learn to fulfill their dreams while being exposed to culturally relevant pedagogy.
Sunday morning at 7:30 on ABC 7.
Looks like we're getting another new neighbor.
Now you could be the millionaire next door. Play Monopoly Florida Edition scratch-off games with a top prize of $5 million. The Florida Lottery. Just imagine.
At Granny Nannies, we provide your loved ones with the care they deserve. Compassionate and experienced help right where you need it most. At home. Visit us at grannynannies.com.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
My mom and I go to a lot of shows and musical theater together, and she has never stopped talking about Ken Christopher in the show Les Mis in 2013. She calls his voice amazing and says he has an amazing personality to match. Today, he's here for our birthday celebration and today's Sounds of the Suncoast.
What do you give to the lady who has given all her life and love to the news? What do you give to the reason you're here singing? I could window shop the world before I'm through. Linda, a sunrise, Linda, the moon to wear. That's not good enough, no, not good enough, not for Linda. palace. Diamonds like doorknobs, mountains of gold to spare. That's not rich enough, no, not rich enough, not for Linda. Linda, a lifetime crowded with laughter. That's not long enough, not half long enough. What can I give you that I can give you? What will your present be? Linda, young and beautiful, always young and beautiful. That's the Linda I'll always see. That's for Linda with love.
Somewhere in your mind, I know. Thank you, Barry. I have to tell you a story about Ken and I. I saw him in Les Mis. I have never seen anybody that good. And then I went to see him in Secret Garden. He was awesome. And so I was in, every time I was the first in line to greet the stars when they came out. And then I said to him, I'm not really a stalker. I feel like I'm a star here. I feel like I'm following you everywhere you go. There's something in my head. And he said, you're a fan. Remember that?
Yes.
I said, this is the first time in my life I've ever been a fan. I like you better than Elvis Presley or any of those other guys. You are the best singer I've ever heard. You really touch my heart.
And you are my best number one fan.
Aww. Thank you. I am really always first in line every time he does anything. Can't wait to see you again. And that was beautiful.
Thank you so much. It's
and
my
so
pleasure.
So perfect that Ken is here to help us celebrate Linda's day.
Song. Yeah, that was an amazing song. Very,
and
very
he
touching.
Has the most amazing mother. I have to tell you, it's not just the man, it's the mom behind him.
We like
he
to hear that.
He's an elephant trainer, so he really comes from good stock.
Mothers like to hear that. All right, coming up, we have a craft that we think actually might be new for Linda. It's hard to find first for her. But first, since we have Ken and Barry with us, we need a professional version of Happy
Uh-oh.
Birthday. So let's do the official sing-along. Take it away, Barry.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Linda. Everybody, happy birthday.
At ABC7, it's all about being here for you. ABC7 News at 7 with award-winning investigative journalist Alan Cohn. In-depth reporting and debate on important issues and stories in our community. With a featured topic of the day and a live roundtable discussion with community leaders and newsmakers. Plus a quick recap of the day's top stories and weather. ABC7 News at 7, weeknights. Now more than ever, we're here for you, Suncoast.
At ABC7, our entire weathercast is dedicated to the Suncoast, and now we bring it to you like never before with the all-new official Suncoast forecast.
Beach and boating forecast. The winds will be out of the northwest at 10 knots.
Now, with the most advanced graphics and technology, we bring you weather where you live, pinpointing right down to your neighborhood.
Zooming into the Sarasota Bayfront,
the all-new official Suncoast forecast, only on ABC7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you. Hurricane season is here, and so is the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7. This essential resource arms you with vital information you need to protect your family and property when severe weather threatens the Suncoast, including how to create your readiness plan and survival kit, shelter locations, what to do with pets, and important phone numbers. Visit mysuncoast.com and download the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7. Brought to you by the Florida Lottery.
Have you ever wondered what it's like to save a life? Find out by donating platelets at Suncoast Blood Bank.
I'm Haley Wilkes, ABC 7. Platelets aid in the clotting process and are vital in the treatment of cancer and surgical patients, trauma victims, and critically ill newborns. It's tough to keep enough on the shelves because they only last 5 days. To donate, call this number or visit scbb.org, and you can help save a life.
ABC 7 congratulates Suncoast Blood Bank on 65 years of serving our community.
We're losing exotic animals on a daily basis, and the ones that we have in captivity are really the ambassadors for their wild counterparts. I'm Clayton Rozier from the Big Cat Habitat and Gulf Coast Sanctuary, housing over 150 exotic animals that needed a great home. And if you love animals, please help them. Do it locally. Support your local no-kill shelters, your local wild animal sanctuaries. Make a difference where you can.
Batteries Plus bulbs keep stacks of batteries for cars, cell phones, watches, plus light bulbs for lamps, can lights, and appliances right on hand. Did I mention we also repair smartphones? Batteries Plus bulbs. Trust the plus. Visit Batteries Plus bulbs today.
Joey, loving making us jib jabs, and we do love to celebrate. Welcome back to Suncoast View, where we are celebrating Linda's 78th birthday today. And a celebration with Linda needs pie, so we're going to check back in with John Parr from Yoder's. And John, we can't talk about Yoder's without talking about your phenomenal pies. Tell us about your summer feature flavors right now. What's in season?
All right, well, our peach pie just got in season, and it's fresh peaches with our whipped topping on top, and we also brought in a chew fly pie and our strawberry rhubarb.
Oh, a northern girl loves her rhubarb. All right, I'm going to ask a very bad question because I bet Linda knows the answer. What is in a chew fly pie?
It's basically a base of molasses and brown sugar.
Okay.
Yeah.
And a southern thing, right, Linda?
Yeah. It is, but I never knew what was in it before, Stephanie. Thank you very much.
Glad I asked.
Thank you. You know, there are not many things I haven't tried at age 78, but this show keeps coming up with some of them. In college, we used to joke about this one, basket weaving. We used to say that you could graduate from any Florida college with a degree in basket weaving. That was before my daughter graduated from University of Florida with a law degree. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's what we say about Georgia now.
Well, I think I want to learn basket weaving. Look at all of these beautiful things. And this is Jeannie Boz, and she is from the
Artful Giraffe.
Artful Giraffe. I love that shop, the Artful Giraffe. And you teach basket weaving.
I do teach basket weaving.
Can you show us?
Yes, I can.
Can anybody learn to do this?
Anybody can learn to do it. I have very small classes. I've never had anybody come in and not be able to finish a basket.
So there's hope for us.
Yes.
You haven't met us yet, Jenny, but we'll try.
Okay, show us how to do it.
Okay, well, you all have baskets that I've started. These are the stakes. They've been put in the base. You need to pick out a color, which is similar to what I do in class. Everybody makes a basket, and they get to pick out what color they want.
I'll do green to match.
Yeah, matches your shirt.
Yes, thank you.
What color matches my shirt? I'll take the purple.
Okay.
Woo.
And, you know, while you divvy that up, I want everyone to know what we're going to attempt to make. Right here in front, this is the basket we're going to try. So hopefully ours will look like that at the very end of this.
And, Jenny, everything we're touching feels kind of damp. Can you explain that to us?
It is. I soaked the reed. I soaked it earlier this morning. So that it was flexible. Otherwise, it's kind of brittle, and as you're manipulating it, it has a tendency to it might break or whatever.
And is this reed a certain kind of wood?
It is. It's a renewable resource. It's a fast-growing jungle vine. Comes out of Southeast Asia.
Oh.
And it's processed there when it comes into the country. And when I get
like
it,
this?
It looks like that.
Oh, my.
That comes in various different sizes. It comes in different shapes. This happens to be flat. It'll also come in round and what we call flat oval. Just depends on what we're going to use it for.
Okay.
So tell us what to do.
So what we're going to do here, maybe I should do Linda's since it's her birthday.
Yeah, we'll help her.
You just start, you lay it in, and you just go over, under.
Do I hold it with a finger then?
Yeah, just hold it down with your finger and just keep going, over, under.
If I come to your classes, how long will it take to make a basket?
The basket that we make in the class, is about 4 hours long, give or take 30 minutes. Mm-hmm.
But you're doing wonderful things like this.
Right. This, keep weaving.
Keep weaving. Stop weaving.
This is the basket that we will be teaching on Monday.
Oh, wow. That's a big one.
And it's a four-hour class. And I keep classes small, so everybody gets a lot of individual attention.
So that's a lot bigger than ours. You make us look like we're
not
trying.
No.
How do I tuck the end? See, I've got it started.
It's already at the end?
No. I mean the first end.
The beginning end.
Oh. Right.
You just tuck it in.
Okay, and then go
behind,
over it.
Yep, we need this.
Now, do people find this relaxing, or do people get frustrated?
Yeah. Mostly they find it relaxing.
Okay.
There are going to be steps.
You see how I handed that off?
I'm sorry, Bobeth.
No. Yes,
there you go. Right,
Stephanie's just trying to make you do her job.
Somebody's good at that.
There are going to be steps that are going to be frustrating sometimes, because it's something that many people have never done before, and so they're learning new things. So it's not necessarily the most relaxing when you're first learning anything new.
Kathy, how are you doing down there?
Over there?
Yeah, hers look like she's almost done.
But
that's what you learn with a law degree.
How to basket weave.
colleges for you, I guess.
That's so horrible.
I'm sorry. I paid your tuition.
Bring this down.
How tight do we make them?
They should lay right
against each other.
On top of each other.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to want to keep this up.
I
think it is relaxing because you don't think about any of your problems. You just think about, I messed up. When can I come to your class? When are
Monday.
Your classes? Monday.
Monday. Yeah, starting this coming Monday. Monday, I have a class.
Is it every Monday or just?
No, it's just I teach twice a month at the Artful Giraffe, one weekday and one weekend, so that people that work regular day jobs will have an opportunity to come also.
And tell us about the Artful Giraffe, because there are some amazing things.
Over one and under one.
Over one and under
one.
Oh, I was going under every one. Okay.
There you go.
Oh, and I messed up my pattern.
Over one.
So the Artful Giraffe is this delightful, happy gift and gallery that is just, you walk in there and it just makes you happy because of the bright colors and the staff and Sue Forbes, who owns it.
Just really unique gifts.
It's really, really unique gifts. They're all from Florida
and
artists.
Or handmade.
They're all handmade Florida artists.
All right, everybody, hold up their progress before we say bye to Jenny. I have one mistake I'm going to hide in the back.
I think you need your class, Jenny. This is really fun. You're doing better than I am. I hate that. Thank you so much, Jenny.
Thank you.
Really fun. I'm going to keep doing this for the rest of the day. I feel better. The Artful Giraffe is in historical downtown village in Sarasota. It's on Fruitville Road. And for class information, you can go to theartfulgiraffe.com. I'm afraid to ask what's coming next. It's a game, and they giggle when they say that. We'll be right back when we finish our baskets.
That'll take a while.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you weeknights at 5.
The kitchen is where life happens. Minnesota Flooring now offers a wide variety of beautiful quality craft-made cabinetry to make sure the heart of your home reflects your style. Visit us today.
from our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC 7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Scott Dennis. Here's what's coming up at 5 o'clock. A ruling in a case involving a Sarasota City Commissioner. Judge announcing his decision on whether Susan Chapman violated Florida's Sunshine Law. Plus, a challenge for scuba divers on the Suncoast to catch as many lionfish as possible. Details on the derby surrounding this invasive species. Now let's get a check on the weather with meteorologist John Scalzi. John?
Yeah, Scott, thanks very much. It's kind of been active this afternoon. We've had a few more showers around. It's been warmer today as well by about 3 degrees than it was yesterday. Hence, a big storm in Lakewood Ranch now in the process of just kind of falling apart in place. The nature of these storms is that they're just not moving much. So, for instance, the one near Arcadia now has grown up right where it is, and it will die right where it is. So if you're under one of these storms, you get a lot of rain. Forecast for the afternoon calls for remaining warm through the evening hours.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you. On the next Black Almanac.
Greatness Beyond Measure celebrates this ninth year with a weekend of activities for youth from 12 to 19 that are powerful beyond measure. The entertainers, speakers, and workshops are audacious and will create a potent mix of learning. For youth will learn to fulfill their dreams while being exposed to culturally relevant pedagogy.
Sunday morning at 7:30 on ABC 7.
Are you one of the millions of Americans suffering from chronic knee pain, arthritis, or osteoarthritis of the knee? Have you been told knee replacement surgery is your only option? Then call the number on your screen and see if you qualify for a breakthrough treatment that is helping people like you find relief from knee pain without pills or surgery. This innovative treatment utilizes an FDA-approved product that replenishes the lubricant in your joints that may be lost over time or as a result of injury. This all-natural lubricant is introduced into the knee where it creates a cushioning layer that protects the joint, helping it to move smoothly and without pain. This emerging treatment is covered by most insurance, including Medicare, and is considered by many to be the first major breakthrough for relieving knee pain in years. So if you're tired of living with knee pain, call the number on your screen right now to see if you may be a candidate for this emerging knee pain treatment. It might be the knee pain treatment that changes your life and gets you back on your feet for good.
Welcome back. We're having so much fun celebrating Linda's birthday. And Kathy, you may not know this, but your mom has some of our favorite moments on the show with us because she always has like this wit and wisdom and one-liners that
wisdom.
She was gives
that
us. That's what we call it.
It.
That's what we call it.
She's so, never called it wisdom.
We're going to play a game of Did Linda Say It? Okay, so girls, you have paddles.
Yes
if she said it, no if she did
of
not.
Of course, at 78, I won't remember.
That's all right.
I
That's what makes the game fun. I'm going
to
read you a quote, and we're going to decide if it truly came from Linda. So
okay.
Here's number one. Did she say, my husband once said that my meatloaf wasn't too bad if you put enough ketchup on it? Did she say it? Yes,
I'm
yes.
I'm going to say no.
And no.
I didn't
Linda?
Think he
yes, he did.
Did he
and
say
he thought
that?
I was bragging about my cooking.
Kathy, is it that bad?
No, well, if you put enough ketchup on it, it's pretty good.
So her cooking needs ketchup.
Her meatloaf does.
Linda
she doesn't cook anything
cook.
Else.
Yeah.
Now, Linda has told us over and over that she used to cook for the four kids for years and years and years. So it's
yes.
not that she can't cook, she's just over it.
I am. I don't cook anything
Did you
but
see
frozen
her face?
Dinners.
She's like, no, I don't think she can.
Did she cook?
Maybe I was too young to remember. She cooks on Thanksgiving and Christmas.
Yeah, but I
no, she calls Yoders.
The older kids are 14 years older than Kathy.
So.
She is the youngest by 14 years, so I was cooking for them long before she was born.
That's how she's going with
Well, you you lived through it, so we guess she
yes,
did okay.
I think she is.
All right, number two. Did Linda say, doesn't matter how expensive your kitchen is if you are a bad cook? Kathy says no. Linda says
I don't
no.
think I
no.
said that.
Well, Beth says no.
Because Linda
she
cook.
Did not say that.
I would love a fancy
yeah,
kitchen.
Yeah, she would agree exactly the opposite.
Because it'll look good even if
yeah,
you don't use it,
have
right?
have a great kitchen, then everybody will think you cook.
Okay, that makes sense. All right, number three with my apologies to Kathy already. Mm. Wow. I've never had two guys at the same time before. If you live long enough, anything can happen.
Yes.
Did Linda say that? I remember. Horrified.
Yes, yes, but it was my birthday boys.
I remember
it was the two
this.
Birthday boys.
Actually,
who were here.
It was when we were doing yoga.
I am traumatized.
And not only did you have two guys at the same time, but they were supporting you. Look and by the way, thank you, producer Joey, for showing us the rest of us in the air yet once again. But she did say that, Kathy.
Wow. I mean, I knew she did. I picked yes. I didn't
you were hoping
to,
no.
I didn't want it to be so true, but I just
it wasn't
knew.
The only time because I did have two guys just now.
You
for
did
my
again.
So like, where is she again. Going with this?
If you live long enough, it'll
anything
happen
more
than once.
Anything.
All right, here's another one. Did Linda say the real reason women don't play football is because 11 of them would never wear the same outfit in public?
I feel like she'll say that too.
As a football coach's wife, did she say that? We got a no from Donna.
Linda, yes, no, I don't think I did.
Linda doesn't know. She's
you know what, Linda, you did not say that.
Oh.
But you know who did? One of our favorites, Phyllis Diller, said
oh.
that. And I think Phyllis Diller's right about that.
No.
That is why we don't play football.
We could get together on something. We could agree on something.
Exactly.
We just wouldn't want to play football.
Probably not. All right, and did Linda say this? I got so good at signing my husband's name on checks
yes. yep.
that one time the bank called to question his signature. Kathy is nodding vehemently. Linda, did you forge Bud's name?
Yes, I did. But but she can forge my name as well
so
as I can.
I am so good at her name, so it's a family talent.
All right, the banks, the insurance companies, we hope they're all not listening. But yes, Linda did admit
I
to being
did.
A serial forger for her husband.
He never wrote checks. He was always busy. I took care of that.
She handled the money and the spending of it. All right, Linda, we love the wit and wisdom, and we
you
look
are
forward
hilarious.
To this spontaneity every single
maybe next
day.
Year we'll have some wisdom.
Okay, we'll go for it. I just want the wit. Next, we're going to dig into the archives to find some fun pictures to share with you. Stay with us.
Have you ever wondered what it's like to save a life? Find out by donating platelets at Suncoast Blood Bank.
I'm Haley Wilgus, ABC7. Platelets aid in the clotting process and are vital in the treatment of cancer and surgical patients, trauma victims, and critically ill newborns. It's tough to keep enough on the shelves because they only last 5 days. To donate, call this number or visit scbb.org, and you can help save a life.
ABC7 congratulates Suncoast Blood Bank on 65 years of serving our community. Hurricane season is here, and so is the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7. This essential resource arms you with vital information you need to protect your family and property when severe weather threatens the Suncoast, including how to create your readiness plan and survival kit, shelter locations, what to do with pets, and important phone numbers. Visit mysuncoast.com and download the official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7. Brought to you by the Florida Lottery. At ABC7, it's all about being here for you. ABC7 News at 7 with award-winning investigative journalist Alan Cohn. In-depth reporting and debate on important issues and stories in our community with a featured topic of the day and a live roundtable discussion with community leaders and newsmakers. Plus, a quick recap of the day's top stories and weather. ABC7 News at 7, weeknights. Now more than ever, we're here for you, Suncoast.
Monday at 5 on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast.
Hello, I'm Rebecca Vargas.
And I'm Don Brennan. The temperature is only going up here in Florida, and so is the risk for heat-related illnesses.
Monday on Good Morning Suncoast, we'll show you the symptoms to be on the lookout for heat stroke and how to prevent it. Wendy?
And there's the possibility we'll start to see some rain coming back in our forecast, and we sure could use it.
Monday at 5 on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
Thanks to my volunteer, I am a better eater.
Thanks to my volunteer, math seems simple now.
Thanks to my volunteer, I discovered new career goals.
I'm a volunteer for Sarasota County Schools, so I know I can make a difference. And you can too. Give an hour, change a life.
Batteries Plus bulbs keep stacks of batteries for cars, cell phones, watches, plus light bulbs for lamps, can lights, and appliances right on hand. Did I mention we also repair smartphones? Batteries Plus bulbs. Trust the plus.
Visit Batteries Plus Bulbs today.
Welcome back. Linda has done an amazing job recording some of her life's fun moments with photos, and you always know where to find them, too, which we are also impressed with. So she's been able to share them with us, and we wanted to share a few with you. So, Linda, you're going to have to talk us through.
I know where they are because I asked Kathy.
Okay. Well, you've always done such a good job.
Oh, my goodness. I was 1 year old. That was 77 years ago. Oh, my goodness.
That's great, with a strawberry blonde hair.
See, my hair was the same color it is now.
She's a natural blonde, whoever doubted it. That's great. And you grew up on a farm, which I love when you talk about.
It was a tiny farm. It was 10 miles from the heart of Atlanta.
Oh, okay, that only gets farmish.
My dad was a Baptist preacher. My mother played the piano, very conservative. Very, very conservative.
And who are you in that picture? Were you the first girl?
I was the tallest girl. I'm the oldest.
And what year was this? Was this high school? College?
This was high school. I was the editor of my high school paper. Always wanted to be a journalist. I wanted to be Brenda Starr. She was very glamorous. She was a comic book character.
What about that hair? It's not blonde.
Hair's not blonde there. Yeah, what happened?
Oh, I am anchoring the news there. You see, we did wear low-cut sleeveless outfits back then. That's probably 1964.
And you were the only female.
Oh, I was the only female in town. Girls were not, and they would have said, girls are not on the news. That's my wedding picture. Bud and I got married in Pittsburgh. That was the year, I have to point out, of the Super Bowl, the Steelers' first Super Bowl. And, okay, Kathy.
Why every time?
I got pregnant at the Super Bowl party, and along came Kathy.
Gross. Gross. People don't say things like that.
No, but we're really glad she does, because that's pretty entertaining. I got to tell you, that's pretty entertaining.
I think it's the response. I love your response.
Just think, Kathy, you were conceived as a champion, and you've been one ever since. How about that? All right, Linda, thank you for sharing. We love sharing you, and we are ready to go to the kitchen with Yoder to get red beans and rice and, of course, Yoder's famous pie.
ABC 7's Pump Patrol, a list of the Suncoast's cheapest gas on mysuncoast.com.
They took that stress and that tension when I was particularly feeling very bad after that nasty car accident, and it was such a relief to know that I didn't have to bear that burden alone, that I had help.
Our goal is to not just get a satisfactory settlement on their case. We want them up on their feet, happy again. They've gotten their life back.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC 7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Scott Dennis. Here's what's coming up at the top of the hour. Their mission, to stop a water park. Why a group of residents are asking Manatee County commissioners to say no to building a water park on Tom Bennett Park. Taking a look at Suncoast Traffic Watch, one car crash at the corner of McIntosh and Tamiami Trail. The car reportedly hit a light pole there. Southbound lanes of 41 are closed. And yes, this is tying up some traffic in that area. Now over to John for more on the weather.
Thanks very much. We are looking at some very rough weather in interior parts of Manatee County today, but those showers and thunderstorms have dissipated just a little bit. Currently at 84 degrees, we are looking at the rain-cooled air in some locations. Where it hasn't rained, temperatures are significantly warmer, with 90 in Northport, 90 in Venice. We had a daytime high today in the mid-90s. Weekend forecast.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you, weeknights at 5. Have you ever wondered what it's like to save a life? Find out by donating platelets at Suncoast Blood Bank.
I'm Haley Wilgus, ABC 7. Platelets aid in the clotting process and are vital in the treatment of cancer and surgical patients, trauma victims, and critically ill newborns. It's tough to keep enough on the shelves because they only last 5 days. To donate, call this number or visit scbb.org, and you can help save a life.
ABC 7 congratulates Suncoast Blood Bank on 65 years of serving our community. Monday at 5 on ABC 7's Good Morning Suncoast.
Hello, I'm Rebecca Vargas.
And I'm Don Brennan. The temperature is only going up here in Florida, and so is the risk for heat-related illnesses.
Monday on Good Morning Suncoast, we'll show you the symptoms to be on the lookout for heat stroke and how to prevent it. Wendy?
And there's the possibility we'll start to see some rain coming back in our forecast, and we sure could use it.
Monday at 5 on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
We're losing exotic animals on a daily basis, and the ones that we have in captivity are really the ambassadors for their wild counterparts. I'm Clayton Rozier from the Big Cat Habitat and Gulf Coast Sanctuary, housing over 150 exotic animals that needed a great home. And if you love animals, please help them. Do it locally. Support your local no-kill shelters, your local wild animal sanctuaries. Make a difference where you can.
Hurricane season is here, and Suncoast weather can go from this to this in seconds. So when severe weather threatens, count on the official Suncoast storm team at ABC 7.
We're armed with the most advanced weather technology so that we can bring you storm warnings faster and with more detail than ever before.
Plus, we focus on the Suncoast and track storms right down to your neighborhood.
On air, online, and on your mobile device, turn to the official Suncoast storm team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today, sleep on it tonight.
Coming up Monday at 4 on Suncoast View, staying hydrated is key to beating this oppressive heat. So Dr. Jenny's going to be here to talk about how to make the water you drink work better for your body. One way to beat the heat is air conditioning. So go to the family-friendly Summer Circus Spectacular at the Railing. We'll have a preview, plus the latest in engagement rings, and Gold Rush Barbecue joins us in the kitchen.
All right, welcome back. Right now we're in the kitchen with John from Yoder's, and you are making really good. It smells really good. Beans and rice.
Yep, red beans and rice. And we're gonna start from with the bacon grease right here.
So I put the bacon grease in here.
That's what I'm smelling.
That's why it smells so good.
Okay, bacon grease. What's next?
And then we want to do the onions.
Onions. This one?
Yep.
Just one of them?
And you didn't even make her chop them. That was nice of you.
Well, I try to help.
It's funny they had to figure out what the onions were, though.
Those are poblano peppers.
These are peppers?
Yep.
Okay.
And then we want to do the garlic next.
Okay. Do we need more of the celery, or is that enough?
That's okay for it. Yeah, that's okay for right now.
Okay.
And then just a little bit of salt and pepper.
Not the whole thing?
No.
Okay, this is salt, right?
Mm-hmm. You have to lay it out for us, John.
More?
Yeah, a little bit more.
More?
That's fine.
Okay. Pepper?
And then the pepper's right next to it. That one's sage.
That's not pepper. No. This is pepper. It has been a while since I've cooked. Okay.
We just want to stir this around. Now, usually you want to let this cook just a little bit first and kind of develop some color, mm-hmm. let the onions get translucent. For time's sake, we'll start. We can go ahead and add the celery to it.
The celery?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And what Kathy's done?
Kathy's chopping some down there, too.
Just chop some more. Put some more in there.
Okay. We'll throw it in when it's ready. And we can put the sausage in, too.
The sausage?
Mm-hmm.
Now, tell us about the sausage, because that tells me that's going to have a good flavor addition.
Now, this is a smoked sausage, and what we do is we actually smoke it. We cut it up and smoke it in-house, mm-hmm. and then we put it in here. We actually double smoke it to really try to get a good smoky flavor to it.
Oh, wow.
And so then we want to add...
How long does this all cook?
This cooks for about an hour. About 45 minutes to an hour.
So this isn't a quick dip.
We've got this thing left.
Yes, we've got that yet. Next, we want to actually add the flour. This one right here.
Oh, this one. Okay. Well, it didn't say flour.
That's true. That's true. And then just give it a good stir there.
With this thing?
Sure, that's fine.
That would be a mess.
And the bacon grease and the flour is going to create kind of like a roux. Uh-huh. And again, you'd want to cook this for a couple of minutes, and it'll kind of develop a nutty flavor. And after that's all mixed
it is.
In
it's,
there.
It's like melting.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that a roux?
Fat and flour makes
a roux. Is a roux like a paste?
Yeah, it's a paste that thickens whatever liquid you're cooking.
Okay.
Yeah.
Makes sense. Okay.
Is that enough, or
that's
do I need
fine.
To
that's
whisk away some more?
That's fine. And then we're going to go ahead and add the beans there.
The beans?
That's this one here.
Oh, this is the beans.
Yes.
With the liquid.
Okay. Yeah, we actually, I pre-did the beans. We want to make sure that they're... any cooking liquid that you cook them in.
Where do you get the beans? Is it the bag or is it canned?
You can use either. We try to use dry when possible, but cans work just fine. Just okay. Make
at
sure
Yoder's, they probably grow them themselves.
And then we like to add just about half that water right there.
Okay, half this water.
Yep.
All right, and while you guys stir that up and work on getting it to simmer a little bit for us, I want to show you some of the other great things that you can pick up at Yoder's Deli. Of course, fried chicken, because what would great carryout be in red beans and rice without the Yoder's fried chicken? So it's a great way to kind of pick up things for your summer picnics, not having to do the cooking at home yourself. There's our finished product of red beans and rice.
Careful.
Beth is lighting things on fire, and I'm getting alarmed next
goodness.
To me. And we also, of course, have the pies, rhubarb pie, peach pie, and candles, and a flower to celebrate Linda's birthday.
And Kathy
and Bill from Giggles with us as well. Kathy Carson, Linda's daughter, joining us for the big celebration. And John, thank you for being a very good sport. And Brittany Pie for the celebration as well. Linda, we wish you many, many happy more birthday celebrations.
I hope I'm here for all of them.
And we love you. And we love each and every day we spend with you. Have a wonderful rest of the day. Be sure to take some time and enjoy the Suncoast view.